How do you clean a steering wheel that's caked with nasty makeup, grease, and grime? Let's show you. What's up, everybody? My name is Phil. Welcome back to Miranda Detailing. Now, this is an older vehicle, and it has a ton of buildup on the steering wheel and all of those knobs. So what are we going to use to clean it? Well, you can use an all-purpose cleaner or a degreaser, and that's completely fine. But be wary on older vehicles, because using high alkaline cleaners like that, even though they clean very well, they can sometimes be a little too harsh for those delicate areas, especially on older vehicles. So here's what we use, the Meguiar's Leather Cleaner. This is a dedicated leather cleaner for leather, vinyl, and plastics. It's pH neutral. It doesn't leave any type of residue on the leather or plastics. It cleans very effectively. And sometimes an APC can actually spot the leather if you spray it directly onto the surface. This does not do that. It is an amazing cleaner. Now, to go along with it, we have their conditioner. Do you use this on the steering wheel itself? Well, let's see. So when you have a steering wheel like this, you could just simply attack it with steam. But again, steam and high alkaline cleaners could cause some damage. So when cleaning areas like this on older vehicles, just use caution. Use the least aggressive method first. This cleaner is perfect. It is a very powerful cleaner, and yet it is very safe and gentle. So we use a detail brush and just work that cleaner into all of those areas, and you can already see that the lather is turning brown. Now we're going to have to work in layers. This is not going to remove it in one shot. So we're going to have to continue to work at removing layer after layer of makeup, grime, and oils. So it may take some time, but be patient. This is going to be the gentle way of cleaning these areas. Now make sure to also have a wet towel, because that will rinse away any of the residue and dirt and leave the area nice and clean, so that you can check your work and make sure that you're removing all of that dirt. Keep working with this method until all the dirt and grime and makeup is removed. But again, don't scrub too vigorously and aggressively. The goal here is to remove layers and not just attack it aggressively. That is pretty nasty. Now, once everything is clean, I'm just going to take a dry microfiber towel and wipe away any of the excess. That way it reveals any little spots that might be missed. And if I do miss a spot, I'll just continue cleaning that area until it looks good. Now here, the conditioner I use only on the center of the steering wheel and the plastic parts around it. Never on the steering wheel itself.
All right, guys, so there you have it. Very simple, very effective. This cleaner is awesome. You've seen us use it on nasty leather seats before, and it cleans very well. And of course, its counterpart, the leather conditioner, also conditions very well. Now, if you don't really want that kind of a finish, this doesn't leave a super matte finish. It is a little bit more satin, and depending on how you want your leather or vinyl to look, you can knock it down a little bit to get more of a natural finish. But you can get that with this product. You just have to knock it down with a towel. But remember, do not put this on your steering wheel. You don't want any type of slippery conditioners on your steering wheel. Of course, it is just not a good idea to put anything on your steering wheel or even your gas and brake pedal, obviously. So those areas should be cleaned, but never conditioned with something that might be slippery. Now, there are some products out there that you might be able to get away with and condition those areas without making them slick or slippery. Dr. Beasley's has some of those products. Now, you can buy all of this stuff, the Meguiar's detailer line, and a ton of other detailing products at Car Supplies Warehouse. So go over there, check that out. They have an amazing credit back system, as well as hundreds of products for you to buy. So guys, thank you for watching the video. Hope you enjoyed it, learned something from it. If you did, give it a thumbs up, share it with others who may benefit, and don't forget to subscribe and click that bell. That way you get notifications each time our videos drop each week and you don't miss stuff. And if you want to pick up some merchandise, then check out the merch shelf down below. You can pick up a t-shirt, a hoodie, a mug, stickers, or even a pillow with Mister's face on it if you want that. So thank you guys for watching. We'll see you in the next one. Have a great day.